Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan. It's been about over a week since I last did this kind of video, my channel update, talking about my life and such. So here I am, just to update you or my future self, whoever's watching this. And I noticed that I tended to kind of think about a topic to talk about and to come up with a title for the video. You know, I'll have a date and then, you know, a title for it. And I couldn't really pick a title for this one. So I just thought like, what? You don't really need a title. So I guess in the future, my channel update videos where I just kind of talk about my life and such, I'll just put a date and that'll be it. That'll be the title. So this is happening on, this is being recorded on November 16th, Saturday, at about 7 p.m. So take that however you will. So yeah, my life so far, this past week, relatively boring, relatively unimportant. Nothing much happened with me personally. But I do realize, like, this is an interesting thing I want to talk about in this video, is that history is happening, like, around me, like, important stuff. So much stuff is going around the world right now, it's crazy, or has been this past week. Philippines, I think, is a big topic right now, because the typhoon that struck Philippines, horrible, horrible, horrible typhoon, what we would call in America, hurricane. It's also interesting that we term it as typhoon when it happens to an Eastern Asian country or whatever. But the typhoon that happened there, worst one that ever happened like that in history. Like, the scale of this typhoon, of this hurricane. Man, just so much damage, so much lives that have been negatively impacted, and you know, so that's happened. You know, situation in Syria is still civil war. China is starting to ease its policy, its one-child policy. In the United States, there are a couple of Supreme Court cases that are happening, that are going to happen, that will decide the fate of labor unions in this country. And it might actually change fundamentally how they work or how effective or ineffective they will end up to be, which is a big, big deal. Less of a big deal, but still a big deal to a lot of people. You know, PlayStation 4 was released. And I'll probably make a video about that, you know, because, hey, why not? Talking about, like, how, yeah. So I'll do a video on that sometime. And then, well, Google Plus integration happened with YouTube. You know, a lot of people are at arms about that here on YouTube. My personal opinion is that I personally like this integration. I've had a Google Plus account for God knows how long, since it kind of started. And what I like about it is, you know, what I don't like is that people are being forced to use Google Plus. You know, that's kind of a bummer. But, like, the new features that are added, yeah, I don't actually mind them so much. No more 500-character limit, better notification system when people reply to this comment, better sharing and reposting, like, so that more people will view your video and view your comments and whatever. I think the idea, and less anonymity, which, you know, I actually value anonymity in a way, so people can I feel like it's important that people get to say what they want to say without the reprisal, without the fear of their identity being, you know, being attached to what they said. And I think this is becoming a serious concern with me. I don't know how I feel. I have mixed feeling about certain stories. Like recently, there was an article I read about how this person, you know, this high school student, he's about to graduate, apply to this college, is completely qualified for this college. The college wants to admit this person based on the qualifications, but this person made a Facebook update that was rather offensive, and made a really negative, just awful Facebook comment on there. And because of that, that student was not admitted to college, and different colleges have different policies regarding if they'll explain to the student why they were not picked for that college. I hope that colleges take the approach of being transparent about that, letting the kids know, hey, you didn't get picked because, look, this is a comment that you made on your Facebook page that is extremely racist, extremely offensive, and it doesn't speak well for your personality or your character. But this is crazy, though, you know, that it's gotten to the point where what we disclose online has that kind of implications. This is probably another topic for another video to talk more about. Anyway, my life, like I said, relatively humdrum, relatively boring. And that's because this ongoing week, I didn't really have anything that was like a big event that happened. Relatively, it's just been kind of the same old routine that I've been in. You know, I have graduate school, I have my internship, and my job, my part-time job. It's pretty much that's been the whole week, except Veterans Day. Veterans Day, I got to, well, I got to play a little bit of just, I got a day off. I played some Battlefield Bad Company 2. I know it's an old game, but, it's my first time in a long time getting back to that game. I was just like, wow. It's like, I forgot how much I loved and adored this game. It's pretty amazing, this experience. I played some single player, played some multiplayer matches, and just revisited that game. And yeah, it's still an awesome game in my book. And then I hung out with a friend I haven't hung out with in a long time. Had a couple of vodka, and then that was a good Monday. It was a good, relaxing Monday, which is a stark contrast to the week before that, which was just a mad rush to get all the papers done. You know, all the midterm papers, I had four, and another paper, and the presentation, all that, just cramming that in there, getting that done, and got that done. Speaking of midterms, I got two of my papers back today. So out of the four papers, I got two of them back today, graded. So one of the papers, I expected it to be not so great. You know, I didn't feel so great about it, and I was just like, I think the best I can get on this is a B-. That's the best. I got a C, so that's about as expected. The other paper, paper that I wrote for Diversity, Racism, Oppression, and Privilege, acronym of DROP, my DROP course, got my paper back. This is the worst I've ever done in my life, like the grade that I got. It's a number grade. It's not a letter grade, but I tanked that really badly. It's kind of ironic because the thing that is taught in DROP course, that is discussed in DROP course, like the subject material, the topic, I feel the most competent and confident about. But when it came to the paper, I just really bombed it. The requirement for that paper, like, I was really frustrated writing the experience. Anyway, the assessment that the professor wrote, is like, your paper seemed rushed and unfocused. I don't know about rushed, because, like, a lot of the, you know, it wasn't rushed, per se, because, you know, I wrote so much kind of detailed, you know, she did say that I spent far too much time talking about one aspect of things. But I think that was like, I just wanted to hone that in. Anyway, unfocused, definitely, but that was because of the frustrating challenge I had with that. I kind of agree with the score, but it's just like, oh man, now I have to do so much better in that class to actually get a good grade for that course, or passable grade, I don't know. So that's kind of a big bummer in my life. But for the most part, you know, my internship was pretty laid back. I had to meet a lot of students. For individual therapy sessions, there was a group thing that I ran that went well. It's been relatively calm because the kids went to this school trip, this camping trip. So most of the kids were gone on Friday. So Friday was like, there were no kids in school to really interact with or have therapy with or whatever. So it was a very quiet day. It was a little awkward and weird that it was like that, but it actually was a very useful day because I got a lot of stuff done, like all the paperwork that I had to do. And in terms of my part-time job, we're still in the process of moving to a different classroom. We moved, but we have to now like organize the room and unpack and stuff, and it's a mess. So the school expects the teacher to pretty much be ready to start teaching by this upcoming Monday. I'm not sure how that's going to be. That's a pretty unfair expectation, if you ask me. But yeah, that's, you know, what I have to say. It's an interesting time to be living in. You know, this history is happening all around me. And in a way, I'm aware of it. But I'm in my personal little bubble here that I really am only concerned personally about, like, what was happening with me, the students that I work with, the papers that I have to write. And I think everyone, in at least in, you know, in America, in Western culture, in Western society, you know, or some other cultures as well, we're living in, like, our private personal bubbles, you know. And I kind of envy the cultures or societies where people are doing things as a community, as a group. This movie, this documentary that I watched a long time ago is, what was it called? Shoot, I don't remember what it was called, but it was about a movie about people in Sudan who had to come to America and how they, you know, readjusted to their life in America, and like how in America, like, everything is so private, but to them that was really hard to adjust because they were always, every day activity was a group thing. They would get in a group of 50 or 100 people cooking together, eating together, dancing together. It was a very group thing. And in America, you know, we live in our own little apartments or little homes within our family units or by ourselves if we're college students in dorms with the, you know, it's a very, like, the contrast is so big. It's like a big cultural shock to them. You know, I'm not saying that I want to live myself, like, I'm accustomed to this kind of private life. But it is something that I'm just like, man, you know, I see the value of that. You know, I see the value of people living as a group, as a community, rather than, you know, separating as an individual. You know, this sole focus on independence, I think, is a very, you know, it's a cultural concept. It varies depending on the culture. And in the culture I'm living in, this is what's valued, you know. Putting yourself through up to the bootstraps and being independent and being an individual and whatnot. And that's valuable too, but it's often easy to overlook some of the other cultures where the independence and the individuality is not valued so much as, you know, how we live together as a community and as a group. But yeah, that's my thoughts of the day, my channel update. I definitely have a bunch of videos that I'm gonna record, probably in these same clothes. I feel like this shirt should be my goat, you know, my recording clothes. I don't know. Whatever. But yeah, take care, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed.